Yes, the NatWest final at Lord's, another year's come round, another big day and a huge crowd, plenty of sunshine and quite breezy out there for the players. £22,000 for the winning side. Middlesex, the holders, and Warwickshire hadn't been here to win since 1968. Well, it was a good pitch. It was very dry, no water on it since a week ago at the Village Cup final. And when the teams were announced, Mike Gatting was pleased to have won the toss and batted first. Let's just take a look at those teams now. The seam attack of Hughes, Fraser, Cowans at Elcock for Middlesex, backed by John Imbury's slower bowling. And then Warwickshire with an option. They have a seam of Smith, Paul Smith that is, Reeve, Small, Donald and Munton, with an option there with Neil Smith and his off-spin. The umpires, Messrs Bird and Plews. Middlesex winning the toss, batting first. We join in the fifth over. It's 11 for no wicket, and Donald bowls to Haynes.
That's Desmond Haynes, a really class stroke. Conspicuous lack of effort. The class players relying on timing.
Alan Donald just over pitching, it's angled in towards the legs and beautifully timed shot.
Well, that's Alan Donald's response. Wow, it's quick.
Not only quick, but also angled in and then moved away, almost like a leg break. Very, very good delivery indeed. And these two now beginning to pose problems for the Middlesex pair.
Gladstone Small.
That's a good shot. Wasn't quite where he meant it. It'll certainly be three the way these two are running. In fact, four.
Alan Donald now goes off, and on comes Dermot Reeve and John Carr.
That's a good shot. Well, that's one where the open face does make the shot.
Yes, I think that shows the pace of the pitch. This ball went out quite a lot off the wicket there. Just a fraction short of a length, but it's still so much time there that Carr could punch that away square on the offside.
Oh, what a great catch. Fine catch by Humpage. Carr goes. Reeve takes the first wicket. All credit to Humpage here, because he's not kept wicket on many occasions this year. He's only keeping in this one-day competition, in fact. And only here comes Mike Gatting. And Humpage has only kept wicket on four occasions in the last 2 months, so to pluck one of those out, it says a bit for him. Tim Munton. Oh, that's well bowled.
Yes, there's still a little bit of movement off the seam if you get the ball in the right place. And you see this one moving away up the hill. That's a good delivery.
Oh, that's close. Huge shout.
Gatting's the wicket that Warwickshire would want, and that was pretty close.
Tim Munton.
And he's gone. Mike Gatting playing the square cut, getting a bottom edge and dragging it into the stumps. That ball not really bouncing, little inside edge, and the second Middlesex wicket goes down.
See the delight there in the Warwickshire players' faces. That's the one they wanted. Mike Gatting will be annoyed with himself because he knows his wicket at Lord's pretty well. It's not coming on, as I just said, and he tries to play a half dab shot. It only has to come back a little bit or keep a bit low, and it's a risky shot, and Mike Gatting there paid the penalty for it.
Mark Ramprakash. Oh my goodness me. And a wicket maiden. And very nearly a two wicket maiden. There'll be two here. Two leg buys, and the 50 comes up for Middlesex. In the 21st over. So after a very bright start, Middlesex being pegged back by the two medium pacers. In very good bowling indeed by Reeve and Munton. Fine shot. Beautifully struck by Desmond Haynes. This is how to deal with a half volley.
Once again, Munton's line was exactly right outside that off stump, but over pitching this time. Beautiful shot, perfect cover drive. It's been the perhaps the shot of the morning.
And that's in the air. Drop at square cover. As Andy Lloyd, the skipper, flashing square drive, but not really a half volley.
No, it was above his head, it went hard, but it would have been a good catch. But I think Andy Lloyd might be just a little bit annoyed at not managing to hang on to that.
Me. Certainly one day shot from Desmond Haynes.
Desmond Haynes certainly showing aggression here, trying to knock the bowlers out of their stride. They're producing a stranglehold here, and both Haynes and Ramprakash look as if they're going to try a bit of improvisation.
Paul Smith comes on. Beautiful shot from Haynes.
Well, when Desmond Haynes plays these shots, it's a very simple game. Foot goes to the ball, a lovely follow through, and that really is how to play on the offside.
That's where Paul Smith's going to get into trouble. He's got this action that tends to take him around the batsman's pads or down the leg side. That's going to be accentuated by this slope at Lord's. Now there's a problem.
Well, you won't see many better strokes than that. That really was timed to perfection. There was a man out deep square, Andy Moles, but he had to go too far, but got nowhere near it. Lovely shot from Desmond Haynes.
There's a man out on the boundary, that's Asif Din. And he's not going to like that very much. Andy Lloyd is going to like it even less.
Well, things just been done wrong by Warwickshire at the moment. They've got a stranglehold on this game. And Paul Smith bowled a very indifferent over. And here we see some pretty poor fielding. Turning one into four. Just letting things slip a little at the moment.
Good innings. Half century to Desmond Haynes. There's a change in the bowling. Neil Smith is going to come in now from the nursery end.
Smith almost getting through Desmond Haynes there, just a little bit quicker than he thought, and the ball going straight on. Oh!
That is the one they wanted. A good piece of bowling. It was a quicker ball.
We expected a little bit of spin, but... if anything, the ball went slightly out, and Desmond Haynes trying to run it away a little bit, making a bit of room, paid the penalty. He'd be annoyed at that just a few minutes before lunch.
Michael Roseberry is the new batsman.
Good tactics by Andy Lloyd. Alan Donald, he's only bowled four of his 12 overs so far. You can bring him back for two or three to try and get a wicket and still save him for the end. Gladstone Small there, just about getting his hands to it. Difficult chance. Bowled in. Alan Donald strikes. Ran for cash out. Bowled by Donald for 24. We're in the 40th over. And Middlesex lose their fourth wicket. Well, far from magical number for them of 111 now for four.
Well, Alan Donald has bowled very well from this pavilion end. I thought he overpitched the ball from the nursery end in his opening spell, but he's bowled two overs or so for one run since lunch. And the frustration telling Ramprakash, it's a good length ball, it's pitching just outside the off stump, angled in. He's playing a cover drive and it goes through the gate, hitting middle and leg, more or less middle stump.
New batsman, Paul Downton. Next man in will be John Embury. And Middlesex still can't get that run rate up to three. Well, that's a fine shot. It's the first one that Donald has dropped even remotely short. And that was smacked away in front of square by Roseby. Splendid shot.
Up till now, Donald's bowled an immaculate length. This is just a bit short. It's only just short of a length. And it's not really a pull. It's almost a forcing shot off the back foot, lofted over mid-wicket. Very good shot indeed by Roseberry.
This could be trouble. If Neil Smith had picked that up, I think there might have been a run out.
Yes, I think probably the fielders got a little bit in each other's way. There's hesitation, and Smith certainly missed it, and probably even then a direct hit would probably have been out.
And that's a big hit. Over, mid-off. First bounce over the ropes. Good strike by Mike Roseberry, using his feet, getting to the pitch of the ball.
Yes, he's been itching to make room throughout the over, trying to get at the off-spinner. That time he did get on the leg side of it, made the bit of room, and hitting the ball beautifully over mid-off. A lovely straight hit there.
And Mike Roseberry coming down the wicket, trying to hit that over mid-wicket.
Well, the effort has to be made. If Middlesex is going to get anywhere near that 220 score, that's the minimum they'll be looking for. So chances have to be taken now.
It's up in the air. Din's underneath it, and that's a wicket. A wicket for Gladstone Small. Mike Rosebery whipping that from just outside the leg stump, picking it up on the up, and finding Asif Din at deep square leg.
Well, you're probably just a little bit unlucky to pick the man out like that. He hit it pretty well, so he's taking a bit of a chance. He's whipping it from off stump, but chances had to be taken, and unfortunately, the first time he's made contact, he gets out.
So there it goes, a nicely judged catch by Asif Din. Warwickshire, after 50 overs, are 148 for 5. The new batsman, John Embry. It's in the air, but just short. There's going to be a run out. No, there isn't. He missed. But my goodness me. It all happens out there. That ball chipped into the air.
Yes, I think it probably Andy Lloyd thought he could run with the ball in his hand to the wicket and beat the batsman. Realised he couldn't at the last minute, had to throw and then missed.
It's a big occasion here, the NatWest final. Lots of ex-players like Colin Cowdery and others here. That is typical Embury. Very, very fast Yorker. You can have no better answer than that. He's given that something. Finished his 12 overs, three maidens, one for 35 now.
Just having a look at John Embry's shot, the one that was a questionable six or four. Umpire Nigel Clough was waiting for some time before he made the decision.
A cracking shot there from Embry. Warwickshire will need to watch this or Middlesex will get away from them.
Embry takes a big step backwards. The ball's pitched on the leg stump. Probably going to miss leg stump when Embry hits it like a shell through square cover.
That's 196 for 5 now. 33 to Downton, 17 to Embry. He's all over the shop at the moment, Alan Donald. No balls, wides, full toss past the batsman.
Well, this almost worked in his favour here. Embry taken very much by surprise by a high full toss. Obviously an attempted Yorker angled in between him and the stumps, but over pitching and Embry not really picking that up.
Up now, five wickets down, and that single took John Embry to 20, 34 to Downton. And another four to be added to that. Lots of edges in the last few overs, but these two batsmen have kept their heads very well.
And the inside edge between pad and the wicket goes for four.
Running. Embury sensed very quickly that Munton had just taken the pace off that, would make it difficult for Small to get in and save the two. And Embury will look for two again. and get it. Good running, excellent cricket by Middlesex to get up past the 200 mark.
210 is still quite a target on a slow pitch, though I'm sure Middlesex will regret the fact that Desmond Haynes, for example, got out just when he was going well. Fine running, I thought, by Downton and Embury, belying their advancing years in the game. An excellent climax to the innings. 211, then, Warwickshire required to win. As for the bowlers, some good economical stuff there, no doubt about that, and the spin of Neil Smith. 9 overs were entrusted to him, 1 for 33, so that's an indication that maybe there's no speed in the pitch, but still good economical bowling by Gladstone Small. 12 overs, 3 maidens, 1 for 35. 60 overs to be bowled, and Warwickshire need 211 runs to win. And that's at a run per over rate of just over 3.5. So let's join them now. Warwickshire batting, second over, it's the fourth ball. 2 for no wicket, Cowans to Moles.
That's a little bit pacey outside the off stump, and there's Downton and Embury again at slip.
Bit of movement there for Norman Cowans. Quite a good delivery, probably a little wide, but people are anxious to score runs in one-day cricket, and they do tend to play themselves a bit wide.
Beautiful shot. That's where I like them, says Andy Moles, just on the leg stump, slightly over-pitched, and he has the perfect shot for it.
And the first change in the Middlesex attack. Angus Fraser replacing Ricky Alcock. He bowled 4 very quick overs for just 5 runs. 2 of those happened to be wides. Short arm jab.
Yes, basically there's nothing for short on this wicket. It's slow, not coming on. You really have to keep the ball up onto a good length, short of the half volley. But Fraser there certainly well on the short side. He'll be annoyed with himself with that delivery.
That's out. The short one, and then the cricket delivery pitched up, and Andy Moles beaten on the forward stroke. The first wicket for Middlesex. Andy Moles, bowl Fraser for 10. The final delivery of Fraser's over, and coming to the middle. A brilliant little left-hander of encouragement. So Cowans coming in for his 6th over. Cowans and going through the gate. Andy Lloyd aiming to hit that through the offside.
Well, the ball seems to be moving more now than at any time. That was an absolute beauty. I mean, that pitched outside off stump, and that's like outside the leg stump to a right-handed batsman. It came back a long way, just missing that off stump.
Has paid off. Kalicharan losing patience, flapping at that one, not really playing a very positive shot at all, getting a little bottom edge, and Paul Downton picks up the catch behind the wicket, and Kalicharan's on his way. Caught Downton for naught.
And this, in fact, wasn't as wide as the other two that he allowed to go, and he ended up really getting a bit tucked up. It didn't bounce as much as he thought. He got a bottom edge. And Downton made no mistake. But losing patience, allowed 2 to go wide of the off stump, and finally perhaps playing at the one that he should have left alone. Kalicharan up for naught, and that's a very important wicket.
And Paul Downton, who batted so well, picking up the catch. And here's his opposite number coming out, Jeff Humpage. He kept wicket extremely well in the Middlesex innings.
John Embry coming on to bowl to Andy Lloyd.
It's a bit of a looser from John Embry, but it still shouldn't have gone for four.
Well, it's wide of the leg stump, helped on its way, fairly firmly. Cowan's in two minds, really, the left-handed pick-up or the big foot, and I would have thought the big left foot might have been a better bet.
Ricardo Elcock. That's hunted away. Although he hit that as hard almost as he could, the difficulty in timing that batsmen are having on this pitch is shown by what happened. The ball never even threatened to reach the ropes, hitting it on the up.
Yes, and Umpage is a pretty powerful player. He's one player who probably can come to terms with this pitch because of his extra power and getting the ball over those infielders.
Brings the 50 up. Was in the air. Fourth boundary for Andy Lloyd.
Yeah, that shows how quick it is down that hill. That really speeding away, and although there was a man back, he'd got no chance of getting to that.
What a good shot. Shot of the innings.
Yes, Andy Lloyd giving this the full treatment. Went in the air, but perfectly safe.
Now Embry again to bowl to this very tight leg side field to left-handed Lloyd. Three men saving the one, three the four. And he's bowled in. That tight leg side field, Lloyd looking to make room to play on the offside. The ball really wasn't there, both in length or direction. Good bit of bowling by Embry. Created the pressure. And that's the end of Andy Lloyd. He's bowled for 34 and now Warwickshire 66 for 3. And we see just which stump that this ball hits. You see, its pitching leg goes on a little bit. In fact, just nicks the middle. And really, if you're going to try and push that away on the offside, you've got to make sure there's some bat on it. It just isn't there to square cut with any power. New batsman Paul Smith. Interesting choice because Asif Din has been batting above him in the order and getting runs. Paul Smith's a good clean strike with the ball. That's four.
Certainly tipped him up a little bit there, and I thought at first he'd completely miss it high up the bat, but it hit it well enough to go for four. And I'm sure Mike Gatting won't really want Ricardo Elcock to be bowling bouncers on this easy pace pitch at this stage. He really preferred a maiden over with a ball on a good length.
No better shot than that. Paul Smith is one of the cleanest hitters in the game when he's striking well.
Well, this was a fine shot because that's not a half volley, nowhere near. I thought it was a good length ball, only just outside off stump. And he hit that on the up, and it really went away beautifully.
This crowd, which has been generally silent all day because it really has been a batting dogfight, everybody's had to work hard for the runs, there's been very few boundaries, nothing spectacular, and suddenly, well, the one-day final's coming alight. Very tense Warwickshire balcony. square leg, and that was a good shot. It wasn't all that short.
Now, this was a fine stroke. It was short of a length, but certainly Paul Smith putting it away, and he's really brought this Warwickshire innings to life now.
And John Carr coming on. Contrasting figures for Jeff Humpage. But again, he's batted much more fluently since tea. Bowled him. Got him off the bottom edge, looking to run it down, and that's the end of an innings which, well, threatened to take the game right away from Middlesex, and good captaincy by Gatting to bring on the medium pacer.
Once again we see it, and if you've got pace on the ball, it is much easier to play these shots, but very little bounce, very little pace. The ability to time that shot against a slow medium pacer like Carr is very difficult, even for a fine striker of the ball like Paul Smith.
New batsman now, Dermot Reeves.
Angus Fraser to continue from the pavilion end.
And that single to Humpage brings up the 100. 111 more required. And a very good contest in prospect.
So Dermot Reeve about to face Angus Fraser. Gatting bringing in the man from square on the offside, bringing him in to save the single, Ram Prakash.
And that's four runs. Genuine leg glance, it was down there. Angus Fraser not very happy with that delivery.
No, he's pretty annoyed with himself. The opening delivery to the new batsman doesn't really want to be down the leg side, and all Reeve had to do was get a bat on it. In fact, I think he got more of a glove on it because the ball bounced, but whatever it was, it went for four.
And that's a tremendous shot, picking that up high over mid-wicket for four runs.
Actually, the first time that Tumpage has opened his shoulders. He's a very powerful hitter. It's a good length ball. It's on the off stump. In fact, it seems away a little bit, but still he gets it over mid-wicket.
Cowan's from the nursery end.
And that's out. He's hit it straight at Mike Gatting in the covers. Norman Cowans picks up a very valuable wicket out of Jeff Humpage. He's played very sensibly and very well, driving at that one, not quite a half of it.
Yes, Norman Cowans has bowled pretty well this match. That was on the up, hit it pretty hard, but picked the one man out there right in the middle of extra cover position. And that really is a vital wicket for Middlesex. It just stops a little bit, and you can see that just going about 3 feet high, straight into Gatting.
And Asif Din.
Gave himself a bit of room there. And it'll be four. Can't afford to do that with just two men on the offside.
Remember, just a little short of a length, but it was a good shot as well. Really rocking that back foot, and a risky player, Asif Din. That was a fine shot.
Changing the bowling. Imbiri has gone off. He's bowled nine for 28 and one wicket. Simon Hughes is coming on.
A little bit of desperation coming into it now.
That's splitting the fielders. Between them, they managed to get it over the rope.
it was a bit of a mix-up. Nobody called. I think Gatting's too pleased. Rampakesh did well. He got a foot to it, but only side-footed it across the line.
Well, that is a tremendous shot. That really is. And that takes it to 11 off the over, and really that's the one that Warwickshire needed to coast for a couple of overs.
Remarkable shot, because he uses his feet, he then gets on one knee and really sweeps it. In fact, it's a lap, it's outside the off stump, but he middles it and it goes for four. And this is an excellent innings. Sir Dermot Reeve is, of course, averaging nearly 50 in first class cricket. He's a man in form, and suddenly there's a match on Middlesex hands.
Also brings up the 50 partnership, which has come up in 11 overs. And with all Asif Din's early trials and tribulations, he scored 21 of them. He's got that one. Third four for Asif Din. An important one at a time when the momentum Warwickshire built up was just starting to be strangled.
Use of the feet gives himself some room. Left pad goes outside the leg stump and times it beautifully. And Gatting, despairing sliding tackle, simply gives away a corner.
31 to win. Well, just about carried, but what a remarkable effort there from Rosebery.
Well, this was quite remarkable cricket. It was an incredible shot, sliced away. I doubt if Rosebery really picked it up too early. It did carry, he did well, but it didn't quite stick.
Must have been close to bowling him.
Well, I think this would also have been a very, very large appeal for OBW, but it must have been an edge onto the pad. It was very straight.
Five off the over so far. Well, that could have been stumped. Instead, four byes. Downton laid nothing on it. Neither did Din. And crucial four. Painful to Din.
Well, this is an extraordinary bit of cricket again. It's an almighty slog. He trips over his bat, he misses it, so does Downton. It's four byes. If it hadn't been, I think he would have been stumped. But this is what happens in the excitement and pressure of these games.
He's given him. Reeve run out. Desmond Haynes does the damage. And with nine coming off the over, Warwickshire had already done what they wanted. And suddenly the one-day nerves take over. Dermot Reeve goes. The end of a fine innings. Run out for 42. And Warwickshire now 191 for six.
I was saying earlier that at crucial occasions during this innings, Warwickshire have lost vital wickets. And here, and he's out. There was no need to take it. They'd had the nine off the over, they'd reduced the run rate, but that was a superb innings by Reeve. He really had measured it, kept at it all the time, done very well indeed. But a momentary lapse there, perhaps thinking it had gone past the fielder, perhaps thinking that Asif Din was coming down the wicket. He got halfway, the call was no, and it was too late for him to get back.
New batsman Neil Smith. Should be two more. More than that. Looking for three. Brilliantly stopped. Elcock it was. Got some of his fielding stripes back there. And that will take some getting. Simon Hughes to bowl it. Asif Din on strike. He's on 33. The light now poor. Just the one. Responsibility back on young Smith. Middlesex have tilted the game back their way. Superb tight bowling. They've never fallen away under pressure. Smith's hit that one. My word, he's hit it. And it's six. Well, if ever a game can turn on one ball, that might just have done it. Well, the first smile we've seen. What a terrific blow that was. Footwork not out of the coaching book, but the ball nearly out of the ground. And suddenly, anything now except a wicket will stay Warwick's way. Three runs to defend for Middlesex and Simon Hughes. Four deliveries left. Well, stopped. Might be a team talk here between Din and Smith. Chat. And he's given a wide. Dickie considered that at great length. No instant signal. And that's why it was comfortably within the normal widths of one-day wides. More vitally for Warwickshire, an extra ball and a run less. Neil Smith gathers himself. Peter Bromwich there seems happy with life. Two runs wanted. And that'll be one of them. In fact, that is it. And Warwickshire win. Neil Smith has grabbed a stump. In fact, he's grabbed all three. One for father, one for himself, and one for who knows. First triumph for Warwickshire in a one-day final since 1968.
Yes, it all looks easy, win by four wickets, but in fact just those two balls to spare. And an innings that stopped and started and eventually lurched forward with a partnership of 69 between Dermot Reeve and Asif Din. Most inventive batting, and then the final slog by Neil Smith. Hard work in the field, some very good bowling out there. Some will say it deserved better. But I'm afraid it went the other way. Mainly seam, and John Embry, his full 12 overs, two maidens, one for 46, the only spin. And the result, great news in the Midlands. Warwickshire beat Middlesex by four wickets, their first win in this one-day tournament since 1968. Andy Lloyd was there to receive the famous silver trophy. And Dermot Reeve was made by Tom Graveney the man of the match. And after the presentation, I spoke to the two captains. OK, Andy, did you back yourself to get 10 off the last over?
No, I have to be honest, I thought the odds were definitely in Middlesex's favour then, and the six by Neil Smith obviously swung the game our way, and what a shot.
Well, has Neil got a history of hitting sixes over long off?
Not really. He tries to hit the ball straight, a little straighter than his father did, I believe, but he's a good striker of the ball when he's in, but obviously in the dark, it's not easy to go straight in and play shots like that, but thankfully he did for us.
What seemed strange, Mike, was that it was a comparatively low scoring match, 220 in 60 overs.
Yes, I said to Andy this morning that it was going to be a good wicket, it was going to get slower and lower, and it certainly did that as the day went on. I think possibly our bowlers, who were a little bit quicker, came on a little bit more, but having said that, the guys bowled exceptionally well, the Warwickshire guys in the morning. I just thought we were 10 runs short of what would have been a fairly good score on that wicket, the 220. I still felt we could nick it though at 210 because we had the guys who'd been bowling well. But they kept coming and going, we kept going out the window and coming back into it, and right up until the last over. I'd have lost my benefit money on that, them getting 10 off the last over. So I would have been a poor man again.
So well done, Warwickshire. Marvellous performance by them. It's great to see a side come back from, shall I say, the wilderness. Well, they haven't had a trophy for some time. They've got one now, and they thoroughly deserved it. From Lords, from us, good night.